Hey everyone, welcome to Capsa. Today we will be diving deep into one of the most widely used pain relievers in medicine, morphine. Whether you have heard about it in a medical context or have any questions about its use for severe pain, this video will cover everything you need to know, from its mechanism of action to its side effect, doses, and the potential risk. Let's get started. So let's break down how morphine works to relieve pain. First, it binds to mu receptors, mu opioid receptors in the brain and spinal cord, which blocks the transmission of pain signals. This reduces the excitability of neurons, making it harder for pain signals to travel. Morphine also inhibits the release of substance P and glutamate, both the key pain-related neurotransmitters. At the same time, morphine triggers a release of dopamine in a brain's reward center, creating a feeling of euphoria. But this is also what leads to addiction. One major risk with morphine is respiratory depression at higher doses. It can slow your breathing by affecting the brainstem centers that control respiration. Lastly, in the gut, morphine slows down movement, which often leads to constipation as the side effect. Now let's dive into morphine pharmacokinetics, a vital aspect for understanding how this drug works within the body. Pharmacokinetics refers to the process of absorption, distribution, metabolism, and excretion of a drug. For morphine, several key factors come into play. Absorption. When morphine is taken orally, it is absorbed in the gastrointestinal tract. However, the bioavailability of oral morphine is only about 30 to 50% due to first-pass metabolism in the liver. This means a significant portion of the drug is metabolized before it enters into the systemic circulation. Second point is distribution. Once in the bloodstream, morphine is widely distributed throughout the body. It can cross the blood-brain barrier, which is essential for its pain-relieving effect. The volume of distribution is approximately 3 to 5 liters per kg, indicating that morphine is well distributed into body tissues. Now, metabolism. Morphine is primarily metabolized in the liver through glucuronidation, producing two main metabolites, morphine-3-glucuronide inactive and morphine-6-glucuronide, which has analgesic properties. This metabolism is crucial for both its therapeutic effects and potential side effects. Now coming to half-life. The half-life of morphine varies depending on the route of administration. For oral morphine, the half-life is about 2 to 4 hours, while for intravenous morphine, it is around 1 to 2 hours. Understanding the half-life helps in determining dosing intervals and managing potential accumulation in the body. Morphine is administered in several ways, depending on the severity of the pain and the patient's need. So the oral route is common for chronic pain, while intravenous or IV and IM or intramuscular injections are often used for severe acute pain. Dosing morphine requires precision to avoid overdose or dependence, and the amount can vary significantly based on individual's conditions. For adults, the typical oral dosage starts around 10 to 30 mg every 4 hours as needed for the pain relief. But this can be adjusted based on effectiveness and side effects. For patients who require IV administration, the initial dose is usually around 2 to 5 mg every 2 to 4 hours as needed. But it can be titrated to achieve pain control. It's crucial to remember that patients with opioid tolerance, such as those who have been using these opioids, may require significant higher doses. Like all medicines or all other medications, morphine comes with its own set of side effects. Common ones include drowsiness, constipation, nausea, and in some cases, respiratory depression, which can be life-threatening if the dose is too high. Long-term use may also lead to tolerance and dependence, meaning higher doses are required for the same effect. And stopping morphine suddenly can cause withdrawal symptoms. Many of you may be wondering how morphine compares to other painkillers you might have heard of, like fentanyl, oxycodone, or even over-the-counter options. Understanding these differences can help you make informed decisions about your pain management. Now, why does this matter? When you are faced with severe pain, it's crucial to understand the options available to you. Morphine is effective for many, but it's not the only choice, and each medication has its own benefit and risks. For instance, while fentanyl is much stronger, it also carries a higher risk of addiction and overdose, making it suitable mainly for those in severe pain or undergoing major surgeries. Always consult your healthcare provider to determine the best pain management strategies for you. What works for one person may not work for another. So personalized care is the key. If you have any concerns about switching medications or the risk associated with these drugs, please leave your questions in the comments below. We will answer as many as we can. Long-term use of morphine can lead to tolerance. Your body gets used to the drug, requiring higher doses for the same pain relief. With that comes the risk of dependence and eventually withdrawal if you stop taking it abruptly. Symptoms of withdrawal can include sweating, muscle aches, restlessness, and even more severe symptoms in chronic users. Lastly, it's crucial to talk about overdose prevention. Morphine overdose can lead to life-threatening complications, particularly respiratory failure, which occurs when breathing becomes dangerously slow or shallow. This is often accompanied by symptoms like pinpoint pupils and loss of consciousness. To counteract an overdose, healthcare professionals use a medication called naloxone, which rapidly blocks the effects of opioids and can restore normal breathing. To prevent overdose, always follow prescribed doses strictly and never mix opioids with alcohol or sedatives, as this combination can amplify the risk of severe respiratory depression. To wrap up our discussion on morphine, let's quickly answer some common questions you might have. How does morphine relieve pain? Morphine relieve pain by binding to mu opioid receptors in the brain and spinal cord, blocking pain signals. What are the side effects of morphine in elderly patients? In case of elderly patients, common side effects can include increased sedation, constipation, and a higher risk of falls. Is morphine safe for long-term use? While effective, long-term use of morphine carries risk of tolerance, dependence, and potential overdose, so it should be monitored closely. What's the difference between morphine and fentanyl? So morphine is less potent than fentanyl, and fentanyl is significantly stronger and often used in acute care settings. How to taper off morphine safely? Tapering off morphine should be done gradually under a doctor's supervision to minimize withdrawal symptoms. Now, can morphine be used for nerve pain? Yes, morphine can be used for severe nerve pain, but it may not be as effective as other treatments specifically designed for neuropathic pains. How long does morphine stay in your system? Morphine can be detected in urine up to 2 to 3 days after the last dose, depending on various factors. What are the signs of morphine addiction? Signs of morphine addiction include cravings, increased tolerance, withdrawal symptoms, and neglecting responsibilities. So thank you for joining me today. If you have more questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos on pharmacology.